when I got saved, God gave me a burden for him. Still have a burden for him today. I cry out Jeremiah 33:3 every day of my life for his soul. And it was in a meeting with us over in Jefferson, Georgia. Talk about providence of God. God brought him from Sylacauga, Alabama to Jefferson, Georgia. Very out of character for him. But as he came, Brother Luther Spivey was over in that meeting and he began to preach on what great love out of the book of Hosea. And as he preached, my dad fell under Holy Ghost conviction. It was real. He began to weep in the pew where he was at. The invitation was given and he came down to the front of the church, and as he got on the altar, he had been sometimes weeping, bitter weeping. He was weeping very noticeably. And if you know my dad, some of you do, most of you don't. He's a long-haired hippie, wears a bandana about everywhere he goes, full of tattoos. Been a drunkard ever since I've known him, and I still believe that my God can save me.
Amen. Amen.
And I believe that he is one day. You say what you want to, but I believe he's going to.
Amen.
But as he got on that altar, and he'd been there sometimes, God impressed my heart to go down where he was at and just pray. And as I knelt beside him and I began to pray, I suppose he heard my voice and he touched me. And I said, "Daddy, what's going on with you?" And he made this statement to me, and I will never forget it. He said, "Son, I want to be saved. I want to be saved with all my heart. I want to be saved. I don't want to die in my sin and go to hell." And he said this, and this is where some of you's at this morning. He said, "But I'm not ready to quit sinning."
Yeah.
He said, "I am not ready to quit drinking." And I told him, I said, "Daddy, until you're ready to quit sinning and you're willing to repent of your sin, then God's not going to save you." There's another time not too long after that. It was sometime down the road that God gave him another opportunity. They brought him from Jefferson, Georgia, from Sylacauga to Jefferson, Georgia the first time. The second time he brought Jefferson, Georgia to Sylacauga. Amen. Brother Whitman, Brother John Moore, several others set up a tent over there in the park, right down the road. By the mercy and the grace of God, by Friday night, that meeting, him and a couple of his buddies, drunkard, hippie buddies, come walking into that tent. Sat down on the back row, right there behind where I was at. Me and my wife was there, she'll tell you, some others, and he was here. But began to preach, Brother Whitman preached, Brother John Morgan preached, and he was preaching on hell, just what this man was preaching on this morning. And as he began to preach, I heard him sobbing in that row behind me right there. Broken over under Holy Ghost conviction. I'm telling you, church, this is serious. He got up, Brother Elliot, invitation time, and got down on the altar in that sawdust. I began to cry out to God for the second time that I'd known him to be under conviction. And at that point in time, Brother, about 8 different preachers from that town crowded around him where he was at and began to interfere with what the Holy Ghost was trying to do. I mean, they was using illustrations such as salvation is just like my watch. I'm going to give it to you. It's a free gift. You take it, it's yours. Amen. And the Holy Ghost had then got him way past that. He had already seen the gift of God. He got up, Brother Elliot, and ran out of that tent. I had to go catch up with him, Brother Perry. He ran out of that tent. I caught up with him and I began to talk to him. And as I began to talk to him, I began to explain to him the saving grace of God. There was only one problem. From the time you get above that altar to the time you get out that tent, conviction was gone.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah.
You say, "It ain't that easy." Oh, it's that easy.
Yeah.
You'll either come when God's dealing with you or you won't come at all.
Right.
And some of you sitting in this building today and you know the Holy Ghost has been dealing with you, he's been drawing you, he's been pleading with you, but But you better mark it down. He said, my spirit shall not always strive with man. He's not always going to plead with you. He's not always going to strive with you. That's been over 15 years. And to my knowledge, he has never been under Holy Ghost conviction again. He has never been in a church door again that I know of. But that don't mean the Holy Ghost can't save you. And you leave out of here this morning if you want to, lost without God. But I'm telling you, it's serious business. Very sober thought again today, amen. And I want to tell you that God's got somebody in this church on his heart and on his mind. Just like he did in Luke 16 when he said, and a certain rich man. You better mark it down. That rich man was somebody that he knew about and was on his mind. And there's somebody in this building once again today that's on God's mind and on his heart. Would you stand with us? Our hearts and minds clear.